Hi, and welcome to this week's edition of 34 News. I'm Evan Goldsmith.
And I'm Allie Brown. Homecoming is just around the corner, and students are busy preparing for the big night. Faculty members nominated 24 active members of the senior class for the title of Homecoming King and Queen. Claudia Ahiavor, Michelle Dioria, Katie Devlin, Stacey Goldberg, Kristen Henkels, Julie Hyman, Kelly Caskew, Megan Kelly, Hallie Mintz, Catherine Pasica, Danielle Porter, and Melissa Setti were all nominated for Homecoming Queen, while Jeff Bell, Nehemiah Bernie Porter, Mark Sakura, Nia Dalal, Nick Giannacci, Dave Ginsburg, Troy Morgan, Rashawn Strong, Rob Ventura, Tom Ventura, Colin Weber, and Sean Young were all nominated for King. The senior class will narrow down this list, and the entire school will vote for the winners. The chosen King and Queen will be announced at Homecoming on November 23rd after performances by the cheerleaders, gymnastics team, and step squad. Good luck to all the nominees.
Recently, DECA went around the school trying to make the students active in their latest event, DECA Dollar Day. They asked people in their first period classes and their lunch periods to donate a dollar. The idea was to let students understand how much a dollar was worth. Not only did they get the point across, but they collected a lot of money for hurricane relief. They are able to collect well over $200 in a single day. Way to go, and now the students can respect the dollar. Now let's go on location to hear more.
Hi, this is Stephanie Rick, and I'm reporting on location with four-year DECA member Lonnie Kay. So Lonnie, what did DECA do to help the Hurricane Katrina relief?
Well, me and my partner, Mikayla Nichols, worked on this as our DECA project, and what we did was went around to homerooms to collect money to send over to Katrina Hurricane Relief, and it was like a one-shot deal going around to homerooms, and the real purpose was to get a dollar from each DECA member, and we have about like 75 DECA members, so we've reached that goal and then got extra money from people just throughout our high school in homerooms, and we collected $275.
That's great. So are you guys sending that straight to the Hurricane Katrina Relief, or are you sending it to like the National DECA Association?
We're sending it to the National DECA Association. We just, we're in process of sending it right now, so hopefully it will get to them soon.
Well, that's great, and that's really awesome that you and Mikayla did that as your project. This has been Stephanie Ricca, and now back to the studio.
This past Tuesday was no ordinary day in the high school. The Diversity Council sponsored participation in National Mix It Up Day. Students were encouraged to break down the walls and get to know other students they wouldn't normally socialize with. During third period, each student was given a bracelet indicating a specific lunch table. During lunch, students sat at their assigned lunch tables along with others from different grades and backgrounds. Now let's find out more about this unique experience.
Hi, this is Lonnie Kay reporting for 34 News, and I'm here in the cafeteria on Mix It Up Day. I'm here with the senior, Sean Young. So Sean, what do you think about this day?
I think it's a good day for people who haven't met each other to just come together and sit at the same table. That's pretty cool.
Okay, and what's your name?
Samantha.
So Samantha, have you found any friends at your tables yet?
Sure, I met a freshman. She was sitting here before. It was really interesting to talk to her and see how she liked the high school so far.
So are you impressed with this day, or you don't really care?
I don't really care. No, actually having a good time, sitting with Sean Young here, my brother, and it's fun.
Well, you heard it here from Spiffy High that Mix It Up Day went A-OK. This has been Lonnie Kay, and now back to the studio.
Last Thursday till Saturday, students from the Svanskotian went to Chicago. They participated in workshops to better their writing. While the students were there, they were given a chance to show off their great writing skills against students from other schools all over the country. They were given topics and needed to write a piece about the topic, and then given a grade on their paper. Caroline DiProspero was our school's best performer. Not only did she get the best grade for the school, but she was given sixth in the nation. She got an excellent on the paper when only five got fantastics. Congratulations to all the participants. Now let's go on location to hear more.
Hi, this is Ann Arison on location with Carolyn DiProspero, who went on the trip to Chicago. So what exactly did you do in Chicago?
Well, it was to a journalism conference, so we flew into Chicago and we went to all kinds of different seminars that kind of explained like different ways to write and different ideas for like columns or different sections of the newspaper. And then we also explored the city a little bit.
Sounds pretty fun. And I heard that you won some sort of award. Can you tell me about it?
I was in a write-off along with three other members of our staff, and I wrote for the editorial write-off kind of section, and it was about, you had to write about National Stand Down Day. It's a topic that they gave you. And so we had to write an opinion piece about that, and then we handed them in and they graded them. So I got excellent.
Now let's go to Arts and Entertainment with Alexandra Santangelo.
Thanks, Evan. On Saturday, November 5th, the Spiffy Marching Band competed at Giant Stadium for the title of Best Band on the East Coast. They came in 9th place in their group. The next day, they won Best Overall in Bloomfield. Congratulations, SPFHS Marching Band.
Really joyous one, because it was like for the seniors who had been with me and even the underclassmen who had been there for a few years, it was just that one big moment that we had been preparing all season for. And it was just that moment of, you know, that final testing moment where we really got to put everything together, you know, and get the final result, so to speak.
So are there any other marching band highlights at the end of the season or coming up?
Well, the end of the season, there was still the next day after Giant Stadium, there was the Bloomfield competition, which was our last competition, our last official competition, which we did amazing at, and we virtually won everything. So that was a good feeling. It was still a boost to know, you know, that even after our biggest moment, or what's considered our biggest moment, Giant Stadium, we still did awesome, and we did our best, and, you know, had our good show.
This week's top five songs on Z100 are Gold Digger by Kanye West, Run It by Chris Brown, We Be Burnin' by Sean Paul, Photograph by Nickelback, and Because of You by Kelly Clarkson. The top five movies are Chicken Little, Zathura, Derailed, Get Rich and Die Trying, and Jarhead. This past week, the casting call was posted for the 2006 Repertory Theater production of 42nd Street. Congratulations to all of those who will be putting on an amazing performance for all of their fans. Now let's see what Mario and Brian had to say about Jarhead.
Welcome to Critics Corner with Brian and Mario, and this week we review Jarhead. First and foremost, I have to say this movie's like really good, and people who are expecting to see like a lot of action in it, you might be disappointed because there's not that much action in it, but there's a really good plot in it, and overall it was good. I can't say anything bad about it. Here's Brian.
I feel the same way. I thought it was a really good movie. I went in there expecting there to be more action, and when I realized that there really wasn't that much action, it doesn't really take away from the excitement of the movie and the plot of the movie. And the acting was really good, and Jamie Foxx was good, Jake Gyllenhaal was good, and I definitely suggest going to see this. Now back to the studio.
Now let's go to the weekend preview with Janie and Lisa.
Hi, this is Janie Weber
and Lisa Campbell
with your weekend preview.
On Friday night, the boys soccer team is competing against Ocean City for the state champions at the College of New Jersey at 8 o'clock. So make sure to go show your Raider pride and cheer the Raiders to state champions.
Also this weekend, you can go to the movies and see Harry Potter, The Goblet of Fire, and Rent. If you feel like staying in, you could rent good movies like Donnie Darko or Adaptation. This has been Janie Weber
and Lisa Campbell.
Back to the studio.
Now let's go to Allie's Alley with sports.
Thanks, Allie. Congratulations to the girls' soccer team for bringing back the first county championship to Scotch Plains Fanwood High School. The Raiders defeated Oak Knoll 1-0 in the county final, leaving their record at 11-5-3. Congratulations also to the boys' soccer team for winning their third consecutive sectional championship. The boys beat Voorhees 3-0 last Friday, November 11th, at home. Goals were scored by Taylor Molinaro, Matt Fleischner, and Michael DeVizia. After a rough start, the girls' volleyball team finished their season strong, winning 5 out of their last 7 games. Adapting to a new coach and returning just 3 varsity players, the team had a hard-fought rebuilding season led by captains Kelly Caskew and Lydia Sams. Now let's go on location to hear more about the season.
So how'd your season go this year?
Our season went pretty well. We had an all right record. It wasn't very good, but overall, I think we did pretty well. I say that we really worked hard together. Everybody played a good part in it, and we had a very young team this year, but I think considering our age level, I think we did rather well.
So who are some of your key players?
Well, the other captain is Lydia Sams, and she's an outside hitter. She's gotten very good this season. We have a setter, Maytal Rosenberg, who's also really good. But basically, overall, I'd say, you know, there's really no key players because technically volleyball is a very, like, team sport.
So you're graduating this year. Do you plan to play in college?
I try out for varsity in college, but whatever. I mean, I could always do club team, intramural. It's always fun. It's a fun sport to get involved with, so definitely, yeah.
New to Scotch Plains Fanwood High School is the ice hockey team. However, this team is unlike any other Spiffy High sport. Each member must supply their own equipment with an additional cost for ice time at approximately $1,000. The coach of this newborn team will be Mr. Howbrook, and practices will be held at local rinks such as Union and Dunellen. Let's go on location for more information.
Hi, I'm Allie Rome reporting on location for Channel 34 News with ice hockey player Alex Bromley. So Alex, how did tryouts go for the new team?
Good. We've had one day tryout so far. It's a 4-day tryout, but it's going good so far.
Do you know any key players for the team yet?
We've got a couple really good players, Nick Raskasin, Max Jones, Rich Kickenwitz. We should have a pretty good team.
So how do you think you're going to do this year?
I don't know. There are some people who have never played before and some who have been playing all their life. So we have a big mix of kids and hopefully we'll do all right.
All right, well, good luck. Now back to the studio.
That's it for sports. Now back to Allie and Evan.
Thanks, Allie. Now let's go to John and Pat with Car of the Week.
Welcome to this week's Car of the Week. I'm Pat Minio.
And I'm John Birnbaum.
This week, you're getting a tour of our house.
That's right. You'll be looking at our domain. Enjoy it.
Thank you.
Now let's hear this weekend's forecast with the Princess of Precipitation, Ann Arison.
Hi, this is your very own Princess of Precipitation, Ann Arison, with the weekend weather. Tonight is going to get really cold. It's going to be lows in the low 20s, so bundle up. Tomorrow, Saturday, is going to be mostly sunny and high around 48, low around 28. And Sunday is going to be high 51, low around freezing, and it's going to be partly cloudy. This has been your very own Princess of Precipitation. Now back to the studio.
That wraps it up for this week's edition of 34 News Update.
Have a happy Thanksgiving, and we'll see you next time.